Hello everybody, I am Jane Gu. Today I'm going to talk about section 6.2 and 6.4. So our first topic is oars. First of all, what are oars? Oars are another way to express a level of confidence about an outcome. Oars are similar to possibilities, but the only difference between oars and possibilities is odds can be larger than one, while possibilities cannot. Another one is odds are commonly used in sports and other areas. For example, whether a sprinter will win or lose a race, or whether a basketball team will make it to the finals. So the odds in favor of events occurring are given by the ratio of the probability that the event will occur to the probability that it would not occur. Odds in favor of A equal to PA over PA complement. Let's do an example together. If there are 3 green socks, 5 orange socks, and 4 blue socks in a messy drawer. So what are the odds in favor of randomly drawing a green sock from a drawer? Let the event A be drawing a green sock. So there are 3 green socks and a total number of 12. So the probability of A is 1 over 4. The probability of not drawing a green sock is 3 over 4. Using the definition of odds, odds in favor of A equal to PA over PA complement. So it's 1, so the probability is 1 over 3. In fact, the odds in favor of an event A can also be found in using odds in favor of A equal to NA over NA complement. So it's equal to 3 green socks over 9 other socks. A common variation on the theme of odds is to express the odds against the event happening. Odds against A equal to PA complement over PA. So those are our key concepts. The odds in favor of A are given by the ratio PA over PA complement. The odds against A are given by the ratio PA complement over PA. If the odds in favor of A are H over K, then PA equal to H over H plus K. So this is the end of section 6.2. Topic is dependent and independent events. In these situations, you are dealing with compound events involving 2 or more separate events. What are independent events? In some situations involving compound events, the occurrence of one event has no effect on the occurrence of another. In such cases, the events are independent. Here's an example. A coin is flipped while a dial is rolled. What is the probability of flipping heads and rolling 5 in a single trial? Here, 2 independent events occur in a single trial. Let A be the event of flipping heads and B be the event of rolling 5. The notation P, A, and B represent the compound or joint probability that both events A and B will occur simultaneously. So using formula P, A, and B equal to P, A times P, B, which is equal to 1 over 2 times 1 over 6, is equal to 1 over 12, approximately 8.3%. In general, the compound probability of 2 independent events can be calculated using the product rule for independent events. which is PANB equal to PA times PB, as we mentioned before. So what are dependent events then? In some cases, the probable outcome of an event B depends directly on the outcome of another event A. When this happens, the events are said to be dependent. The conditional probability of B, PB/A, is the probability that B occurs, given that A has already occurred. Thus, the probability that both events will occur is given by the product rule for dependent events. But the probability that both A and B will occur equals the probability of A times the probability of B given that A has occurred. Let's do an example together. Serena has a computer. Her computer sometimes crashes while she is trying to use her email program. Outtake. When Outtake hits, stops responding to commands, Serena is usually able to close Outtake without a system crash. In a computer magazine, she reads that the probability of Outtake happening in any 15-minute period is 2.5%. While the chance of Outtake and the operating system failing together in any 15-minute period is 1%. So if Outtake is happening, what is the probability that the operating system will crash? Sabrina is wondering. Let event A be outtake handling, and event B be an operating system failure. Since event A can trigger event B, the two events are independent. So the data from the magazine tells you that PA equal to 2.5% and PANB equal to 1%. Therefore, using the formula PANB equal to PA times PB/A. So PB/A is equal to 1% over 2.5%, which is equal to 0.4. So there is a 40% chance that the operating system will crash when Outtake is handling. Here are the key concepts we learn in this section. If A and B are independent events, then the probability of both occurring is given by PANB equal to PA times PB. If they are independent, PANB equal to PA times PB/A. Thank you for watching this teaching video.